You are talking with Macron, his special envoy, to discuss AI governance, regulation. You've got a summit coming up in February where you want not just nice to haves, but actions to have. Is it governable from a world perspective?
Well, that's a great question. Thanks for having me. We're at early stages of AI, and I think this is now is the time where we need to put all our efforts into this, into looking at how we want to govern it, how concrete action can be taken, can be scaled, can be catalyzed to get AI to be developed in the interest of people. I mean, I very much agree with a lot of what has just been said recently. So we need to redouble our efforts and get heads of states, and but also civil society, startups, large companies, researchers, very importantly, together to best address those subjects.
What's the number one concern?
Well, there's been lots of discussions around AI safety at previous summits, like at Bletchley Park and Seoul. We want to take a broader approach because we do think those are important topics, but we also think we need to discuss things like future of work. You had an example on that just before. Innovation and culture are very important topics. But most of all, it is what can we do to make sure we put into perspective the potential harms and of misuse, and then the benefits and opportunities, and help steer things in the direction of these very concrete opportunities. And when I say very concrete, you can say AI is going to benefit health, for example. Yeah, but not everything in health. Some very specific cases of, for example, orientation, speeding up taking care of patients, or speeding up drug development, but not everything, not replacing doctors or nurses on everything.
And good morning.
Good morning.
Mistral in France is the private sector leader in AI. How closely are you working with Mistral in your efforts?
So, first of all, this is a global summit that we're preparing. So I'm really keen to work with all AI companies and startups like Mistral, but also the ones in the US, which you know super well, the ones like Sakana in AI in Japan or Aleph Alpha in Germany. And yes, we work very closely with Mistral, but I'm also very pleased that we have other great startups in France like Poolside or H, just to name a few.
Yes.
So yes, we're working with them.
I'd like to know about Macron's attitude towards leadership. How important is it for a global leader, a Western world leader, to have a firm grasp on artificial intelligence, the technicalities of it, the implications of it, and how does he feel about that?
So it's really a subject that he's been deeply interested in for years. France had a first report and set of recommendations on AI in 2018, led by Cédric Villani, our a field medalist. I just recently co-chaired the second report with economist Philippe Aguillon. We delivered our recommendations in March. This is really something that the French president, Macron, is very interested in and following on quickly, strongly and regularly. He's speaking at a number of events on the topic. He's listening to people as much as he can. Yes, he strongly believes this is important.
It's all very well for a Western leader, as Ed says, to be on top of AI. But what the United Nations has been trying to say is there's a whole load of other countries who are impacted by this, who have no seat at the table. We look towards your summit, which yet again involves a lot of the people who've been in the UK and Seoul, and it's a lot of the same G7 countries. What about involving Africa, the global south?
This is super important. We have a bit more time, luckily, to prepare our summit. The UK and South Korea had to really do things quite quickly. Because we have more time, we really want to be as inclusive as possible. We've already sent save the dates to more than 60 world leaders. We're really opening this up to as many countries as want to come, as well as startups, enterprises, civil society organizations. We held a webinar recently with more than 250 of them from around the world, researchers, of course. really, France has this at heart, to really take into account the perspectives and interests of countries around the globe. I completely agree with you. If AI is only being developed by a few actors in a few countries, we will have failed. We really need to involve everyone and make sure we steered it towards the towards peoples and society.
And look forward, what are the objectives that you're setting for yourselves as a result of the summit?
So we're at the same time very ambitious and also very humble and pragmatic. We want to use the dates of the summit to catalyze, to scale, to take specific actions that are as pragmatic and concrete as possible. We want to have examples of specific use cases in specific countries versus a general discussion on science fiction or potential impacts. And we also want to have concrete actions on standards, on interoperability, on specific initiatives involving a number of countries and private actors and public actors. You'll have to wait a little bit until February, but I very much hope that you can be there and that we can have these concrete actions and results be presented there.